Problem number 2, theoretical vapor compression cycle with wet vapor after compression. The question is, an ammonia refrigerating machine fitted with an expansion valve works between the temperature limits of minus 10 degree Celsius and 30 degree Celsius. The vapor is 95% dry at the end of isentropic compression, and the fluid leaving the condenser is at 30 degree Celsius. Assuming actual COP as 60% of theoretical, calculate the kilograms of ice produced per kilowatt hour at 0 degree Celsius from water at 10 degree Celsius. Latent heat of ice is 335 kilojoule per kg. Ammonia has the following properties. So again, here the chart is given to us, temperature of 30 and minus 10 degree Celsius, then liquid heat. Again, in bracket they have directly given the notation. So in this problem there is a big hint for us, HF. Then again, latent heat, HFG, in kilojoule per kg value is given. Liquid entropy, SF, is given. And total entropy of dry saturated vapor, it is given to us. So first we will again understand the meaning of this problem. An ammonia refrigerating machine fitted with an expansion valve works between the temperature limits of minus 10 degree Celsius and 30 degree Celsius. So directly we know that minus 10 degree Celsius is evaporator temperature, which is the lowest temperature in the system, and 30 degree Celsius is the condenser temperature, which is the highest temperature in the system. So vapor is 95% dry at the end of isentropic compression. So directly from this sentence we can write that after compression, that is the end of compression, is 0.2, and so 0.95 is the value of x2, and the fluid leaving the condenser is at 30 degree Celsius. So the fluid is leaving the condenser at 30 degree Celsius. Actual COP is 60% of theoretical. So once we calculate theoretical COP, then actual COP will be 60% of theoretical. What we have to find is how much kilograms of ice is produced per kilowatt hour at 0 degree Celsius from water at 10 degree Celsius. So the meaning of this problem here is that water is given at 10 degree Celsius and we have to form the ice, which will be at 0 degree Celsius. So the temperature difference will be 10 minus 0. So delta T will be 10, and in that the kilograms of ice, how much kilograms of ice has been produced, that we have to calculate. So for that, latent heat of ice is given as 335 kilojoule per kg. If it is not given in the problem, this value we should know, latent heat of ice, 335 kilojoule per kg. So as always given, T2 equal to T3, 30 degree Celsius, that is condenser temperature, so 303 Kelvin. T1 equal to T4, minus 10 degree Celsius, so 263 Kelvin. As we have explained, X2 95% dry, so 0.95. HF2 is equal to HF3 as per the last problem again, 323.08. HF1 equal to HF4, 135.37. Latent heat is given, so HFG2, 1145.80. HFG1, 1297.68, SF2 1.2037, SF1 0.5443, and the total entropy values which are given, total entropy will be on the saturation curve. So on saturation curve we have 2 dash point and 1 dash point. So S2 dash, that is at 30 degree Celsius, 4.9842, and S1 dash is 5.4770. So the problem will be again started with entropy at 0.1. So entropy at 0.1, again the formula will be same, latent heat is given. So S1 is equal to SF1 plus X1 HFG1 divided by T1. So here X1 is again unknown. So when we formulate the equation here, S1 is equal to, in terms of X1 we will get, that is 0.5443 plus 4.934 X1. So we are calling this as equation number 1. Entropy at point 2, again the formula will be same. S2 is equal to SF2 plus X2 latent heat, that is HFG2 divided by T2. So X2 is 0.95, so we will get a whole value here. So S2 we get as 4.796, which is called as equation number 2. So again, as per all the problems which we have seen, since from TS diagram, S1 is equal to S2. So as S1 is equal to S2, we get S1 is this equation and S2 is this value. So we get X1 as 0.86. This is the dryness fraction at 0.1. So after calculating entropies, now enthalpy at 0.1, H1 is equal to HF1 plus X1 HFG1, all values are known. So we calculate H1 as 1251.4 kilojoule per kg. Similarly, enthalpy at 0.2, H2 is equal to HF2 plus X2 HFG2, all values are known again. So we get H2 value as 1411.6 kilojoule per kg, and then the theoretical COP, H1 minus HF3 divided by H2 minus H1. This is the same procedure which we have adopted for all the problems. So theoretical COP is 5.8. Now in this problem some extra points are given, so we are going to next point directly. Actual COP. Actual COP was to be calculated as 60% of theoretical COP. So 5.8 is the theoretical COP into 60%, that is 0.6. So we get actual COP as 3.48. Then work to be spent corresponding to 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3600 kilojoules. Now see, for calculating per hour, we get for value calculating of 1 kilowatt per hour value, we require W is equal to 3600 kilojoules. The work is to be spent so that the value will be 1 kilowatt of power. So actual heat extracted, that is nothing but the refrigeration effect. So refrigeration effect produced per kilowatt hour we have to calculate. We know the formula of COP. COP is equal to refrigeration effect by work done. COP is equal to refrigeration effect divided by work done. So refrigeration effect is equal to work done into actual COP. So work to be spent we have formulated here. So 3600 multiplied by actual COP. So we get the value as 12528, that is 12528 kilojoules. So heat extracted from 1 kg of water at 10 degree Celsius for formation of 1 kg of ice at 0 degree Celsius. So it is a easy equation, mcp delta t, as we calculate for the heat removal, plus the latent heat of ice. So here mass is 1 kg. So 1 into Cp will be of water, because we are converting 10 degree Celsius of water into 0 degree Celsius of ice. So Cp of water is 4.187 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Delta T is 10 minus 0. So it is 10 plus latent heat of ice is 335. So the value is 376.87 kilojoules. Now we have to find the last point, amount of ice produced. So how much kg per kilowatt hour the amount of ice is produced, that is how much kg of ice is produced. So here 12528 divided by 376.87 kilojoules, and so we will get 33.2, that is the kilojoules per kilowatt hour the ice is produced. So the amount of ice produced is 33.2 kgs per kilowatt hour.